So, tiket tu kena beli ke? Tak perlu beli. Tunjuk yang pass national park pass tu je dapat free. Tunjuk, nanti dia akan bagi tiket untuk naik bus. Dekat counter tadi. So, siapa ada national park pass tu dia dapat free. Bus lah. Kita sini.
Just the old one. So, Lake St. Clair in the south. Rated in the top 10 in the world, and over 8,000 people attempt it each year. It takes most of them 5 or 6 days to do so. Some people take a little bit longer doing side hikes and hanging out at the huts. Once a year though, there's a mad bunch of people that will decide to run the track. It's called Cradle Mountain Run. And the record still, to this day, 7 hours, 25 minutes. Oh, I reckon you cheated, huh? Got a helicopter. Ronnie Creek's also home to Allhine Chalet, a very historic chalet, originally built in 1912 by an Austrian bloke called Gustav Weindorfer, and it's Tasmanian way. Now, they built Allhine for accommodation before this place was a national park. And it's pretty much thanks to them that we actually have this place. It's built out of the local King Billy Pine, and time to check it out, it's certainly well worth it. So once we drop down into Ronnie Creek itself, if you're walking from there towards Dove Lake, Lake Lilla, Crater Lake, Crater Peak, Crater Falls, Marion's Lookout, or you're going to Waterline, and you want to be starting on the overland track on the right-hand side of the road, and the sign says overland track. If you're walking back to where we've pretty much just come from, when we drop down into the valley, there'll be a boardwalk on our left-hand side. That'll take you all the way back to the Ranger Station Interpretation Centre.
How far is that?
5.5 km.
Thank you.
Welcome. If you've had enough, you can do a section and just go to Snake Hill and then get a bus from there. That V shape is Crater Peak. As the ridgeline continues along to the left and then drops off the edge all of a sudden, that's Marion's Lookout. To the left of Marion's, the double peaks of Cradle, so she is out in all her glory today. To the left of Cradle, we can't quite see it yet, Hanson's Peak. And once we come up this little hill here, directly in front of the bus, the big mountain with no trees on top, that's Mount Campbell. So there are all the peaks and lookouts that surround us up here in the Cradle Valley and keep us all nice and protected. So if you are going up higher this afternoon, folks, Marion's Lookout and Hanson's Peak are around about a 3 to 3.5 hour return walk to the summit of each of them. The Cradle Mountain Summit, well, that's a minimum 6 to 10 hours return. Last bus is at 5:30, so good luck with that one. The most popular walk down like the Dove Lake Circuit, 6 kilometres around the lake, takes about 2 hours, a mixture of boardwalk and track. We highly recommend you do that particular walk in a clockwise direction, so left side of the lake to the right. The reason we say this is it just makes things a heck of a lot easier if everybody's walking one way and the same way around the lake at the same time. Shorter walks, you've got Glacier Rock, 10 minutes each direction, left hand side of the lake. Follow the track around to the left, you'll come to a set of stairs. Top of those stairs on the right, you'll find a gate. You go through the gate, and that'll put you on top of the rock. Boat shed, another good little one, 10 to 15 minutes each direction. Right.